Let me just start with you, Dr. Mulyale, to understand from you, based on all of this, all of these different numbers and trends that we're seeing, what is it looking like to you? Are we likely to see some kind of Omicron-fueled third wave in India, or not really?
It would be very easy to answer yes or no, but I am tempted to paraphrase it in terms of it was a shifting value system that we had to have. Initially, this came so rapidly with the doubling time in certain areas, 2 days, it was frightening. But at the same time, it wasn't making any waves in terms of hospitalization, like you said. So that was a consoling thought. But the most important thing, or a piece of evidence that you narrated just now, is the rapid fall in South Africa. Remember, compared to Denmark, South Africa's method of collecting data is nowhere. Mm. So it looks like countries will have a good system of documenting all the new variant on testing, have a higher rate of the Delta. On the other hand, one little information you left out in your presentation, we, like South Africa, have a huge naturally acquired immunity. And I think of late studies have shown that makes a huge difference. Now that is what I think India's trump card is. More than 80% have acquired immunity through infection, plus the 140 crore doses of vaccine. Given this background, we have to understand that we are in a great shape to face this Omicron.
Okay.
The wave may be there, but unless it creates a consequence in terms of health, then it is not to be worried about.
Okay, interesting.